里快马递送，圣经将军宝兴。
吏部咨文，四百里快马递送，直隶总督齐善。
兵部火票，五百里快马递送，湖广总督林则徐。
鸦片泛滥，已成天朝心腹大患。臣以为，如果再犹豫不决，不需十年，大清朝便内无银两，外无兵防。洋人不费一枪一弹，就可使我亡国灭种。
大胆！
老爷，湖广总督林大人来访。哎，
小莫，这
啊，这是洞庭湖底的一枚千年水胆，据说服用以后可以立即断掉鸦片烟瘾，恩师不妨一试。
惭愧啊，老朽六十年宦海沉浮，谁料木言竟折倒在烟枪之下。少墨，可知皇上这次为何传你进京吗？
想必是为了历尽鸦片之事吧。
鸦片乃中华千古未见之物，迷人心性，毒害苍生。老朽尚且如此，京城里的王公贵族就更不用说了。不过以老朽之见，鸦片虽然凶险，但要历尽鸦片只怕更加凶险。
学生愿听恩师指教。
禁烟之难，只因如今外有海关受贿，内有权臣贪赃，再加上圣意多变，这禁烟实在是祸福难料啊。宫中答对时，你万不可贸然应命啊。
学生一定牢记恩师教诲。哦，这是学生近日之所想，请恩师指教。
你还是那样年轻气盛啊。恐非吉兆。
林则徐，你是朝廷重臣，如今鸦片泛滥，你有何对策呀？
臣以为，只要皇上发出严旨，内阁立法，边关厉行，鸦片就一定能够禁绝。
哦，会有这么容易？
天威所致，四海清平。
既然你如此自信，朕希望你能够担此重任， 前往广东扫平鸦片。
微臣深蒙皇恩，本当万死不辞，只是臣近年来常为内疾所苦，臣不惧粉身碎骨，只怕力不从心，贻误了万岁的禁烟大业，罪莫大焉。
朕略通脉理，待朕与你详查，将脉来。脉象大乱，要不要朕给你开一剂药方啊？
啊，微臣不敢。
林则徐，你的病因有三，其一，你怕朕与你重任，却不授你大权，使你左右受制；其二嘛，你怕朝中的大臣非议，使禁烟半途而废；这其三，你更怕的是，朕决心有变，朝令夕改，使你祸福难测。以上三者，是也不是？
万岁，洞察秋毫，微臣确实有这三句。可是臣不惧自身的祸福，只惧天朝的兴衰。先朝自世宗七年下戒烟令，迄今已经有109年了。可是鸦片为什么越禁越盛？如果此次禁烟再是中途而废，那么华夏怕是永远没有人再敢言禁烟二字了。
你呀，还是信不过朕。朕再让你看一剂药方。不想为你的恩师求情吗？
万岁，恩师年逾古稀，一贯是忠心耿耿。
吕子方不但是你的恩师，他也是朕的开蒙老师。朕5岁的时候，他教过朕水墨丹青；6岁的时候，他教过朕四书五经。可是如今呢，鸦片居然祸及王公大臣，堂堂天朝圣地，居然成了大烟馆。千年水胆只能救一个烟民，可朕要的是整个天朝。传旨，将吕子方封门罢官，叫刑部严处。
少穆啊，皇上杀我是为了向天下人证明的禁烟的决心，也是要断掉你禁烟的退路。少穆，你去吧，老朽的人头为你祭齐了。少穆，老朽的头为你祭齐了。少穆，你去吧。少穆，
则需接旨。鸦片不绝，誓不还京。
Yes, it's only a game.
It's China! It's China!
爸爸，你 really going ashore?
Yes. Go on, you better get changed. Qing government doesn't welcome young gals.
God be with you always, my son.
Thank you. I like the story about Jesus. Unfortunately, books of this kind are forbidden in the Celestial Empire. I can take it ashore with me.
Perhaps one day that will change, Ho Shan Yu. Oh.
Captain White.
Ah, ha ha. Gracias, buon giovane tuendo, Kaiser. Dong ho, ninien go.
Inspector!
钦差大人，即日到达广州，你们务必遵守法令，处处小心。
是天天都说你，我是孩子，回来就好。
哎呀，都说少爷出事了，老爷就是不信。
孩子，咱们义和行如日中天，岂容你一去不返？我的孩子，
爹，孩儿海上落难，幸亏杨船金枪号搭救，当作水手，才得以随船归来啊。
金枪鱼号，那不是英人颠地的船吗？我可让他发了不少的横财呀、啊！这怎么着？他敢把你当水手来用？
刚，哎呀，邓大人王叔堪为古今一绝呀！啊，
我看他浑身是眼，掌上有神呐、啊！
据说这是林钦差平生最得意的对子。邓毛以为啊，这个笔墨啊，如同官场，一刻而与同工。这两者是丝毫也不得错失的。方才似有一道四百里船牌，我想当时林则徐发来的。
果然。
林钦差现在到了什么地方？
据报，他星夜兼程，已过南昌府。
哦，千里之外杀人的船牌就知道了。
林则徐的细作密使早已潜入广州，我等恐怕也在他耳目查探中啊。
此乃敲山震虎，用心良苦啊。
天帝呀、啊、天帝，小儿在南洋落难，多亏你搭救，把他当成水手来用。
My father said, "Thank you for taking care of me."
好，请，里边请。
Please, this journey is unbelievable.
Miss Mary, what's this?
Mr. Franklin, try some of the chicken, right?
蓉儿，
是。
来，我请大家喝酒。来。
Very good health.
师傅。
一满小木。
最近听说云泽徐要禁烟，在京城里皇上在八天之内召见他八次之多。
My father is told 林则徐 wants to ban opium, and he wants granted an audience with his majesty eight times already.
Eight times? Well, I'll just have to send him eight times as many gifts of silver.
对呀，他要给他八倍的银子啊，
就怕林大人他不会收。
来来来，大家喝酒啊！耶！
我爹年岁大了，等他一过世，我就把你给娶过来。
公子说的是假话。是你们让我抽的，说是大烟能治百病。我不卖唱，不卖身。
嘿，可如今你一天要抽六个大烟泡，我拿什么给你去买去？难道我会额尽尿银不成？
客官，
不够吗？上好的鸦片，
不，不是。
我的钱，我要你陪我一个晚上。
和洋人睡觉？
为什么？为什么不？
我也学男人。Whoever it is, I'll just have to wait outside.
Longer.
哦，原来是何公子和杨小姐啊。
外面有官兵，让我们进去躲躲。
龙儿，
大人他
禀大人，船过北关之后，林大人便弃船登岸，令林生护送关防。
刚过南城，
卑职失察，惭愧惭愧。
邓茅爷并非是浑身是盐呐，
我想林则徐定在城中探访。
速传韩总兵，将林大人船牌上所要的重要烟贩，立刻押送平城，就地正法。
Will you come and take a look at this? By taking the heads of their own people, they seek to intimidate us.
Yeah, I think they do. There's an old Chinese saying, kill the chicken to terrify the monkey. Those convicts are the unfortunate chickens. And we gentlemen are the unwelcome foreign monkey.
This dreadful business right beneath our
natural flag. Help! 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 Mr. Dent, help me!
Dent,
help
me!
Help!
Oh, no. Help!
Mr. Dent, help!
Daddy, do something! Then you can't just leave him there.
Hey, what's happening? Happen
to me? He's my friend. Let him go.
He said what? He said he knew the old man. Ask the old man to spare Lu Cai a life.
胡言乱语. This 蛮女 how can she recognize my 天桥命官?
He said he met the old man on the 金枪鱼号 If the old man is small, he will go to他就要向林青山告状啊！大人，求求你饶了小的，好吗？大人，
等等，大人 ，Mary，
没有了 ，Mr. Dan，Mary，
啊
，Mr. Dan，
我的女儿，我的女儿 ，Come here，
大力，
放开走。
林哥，让我来。这位客官，那个人他是义和行的何公子，不是什么烟贩子。
两广总督邓大人同一大人官将军谈到的。
哦，来得好快啊，让他们暂停行刑。
三位大人安康啊！
林大人，我等有失远迎，赎罪了。
来来来，请上面用茶。关将军，请。
林大人，
关将军，
监听犯人名叫何善之，是义和行行主何敬龙的公子，属下已吩咐人严加看管。
哦，果然是何公子，明天一早带来见我。
这
儿，来，进来。你。勾结洋人，贩卖鸦片，害我天朝，你可知罪？
小人冤枉，小人绝对没有贩卖半点鸦片。小人出海在外，做的只不过是茶叶、瓷器和布匹的生意。昨日小人才从海外回来，对家父和义和行的生意也一无所知，请大人明察啊。嗯，
我听你能够讲洋话。那么，你认识杨四吗？
钦差大臣林则徐，祖籍福建，家族穷苦，20岁成为举人，27岁考中进士，为官至今。 在盐政、海运、治河多方面政绩昭著，深受皇帝的信任。此人杀伐决断，心深不可测。
好了好了，洋人的消息一向是这么迅速吗？
是，洋人以为谁知道的早，谁知道的多，谁赚的钱就多。
嗯，所谓知己知彼，方能百战不殆。那我再问你，你知道洋人是怎么赚钱的？你知不知道洋人是怎么造船造炮的吗？
小人略知一二。
嗯，
这些年来，小人在海上航行，才知世界之大。
我要以昔人之长，补天朝之短。你也可以此将功折罪。
小人谢恩。
先生年幼无知，准你改过自新。我留你做通事，查询洋务，限你三日之内将英国国主是如何处置鸦片的查个清楚。
小人愿效天马之劳。
你罪可赦，你父亲之罪却不可赦。这铺天盖地的鸦片是从何而来？
大人饶命啊！
洋船入关，啊，都是由你们这些人出面担保，声称绝对没有鸦片，官府这才准其入港。可是现在呢？嗯，鸦片的流毒四海，百姓家破人亡，我大清的文银一失殆尽。啊，看看你们今天却以这样一件破补丁衣服来欺骗本部堂。谁不知道你们这些人富甲天下？嗯，何景荣，
小民愿捐全部家产报效。
不但要没收你的家产，我还要你的脑袋。官府当中有什么人与你沟通？
你虽有万贯家财，也还是一介小民呢，何能如此倒卖鸦片？嗯，官府定有内助。
哼，还不快从实招来！
小人犯罪，万万不可诿过于官府。多年来，官府时时训诫小民守法，都因小民不听教诲，贪婪获罪。
我命你传谕洋商，告诉滇地等人，我天朝皇帝恩比四海，怀柔天下，因此才准予他们与我们通商。那么感恩当知守法，利己不可害人。
老夫的性命不保，你们的黄金日子也快到头了。
My father say, my days are numbered. So are your golden days.
The king government takes us as criminals.
Gentlemen, gentlemen, it's time to take a vote.For me, money's like the trade winds. Easy come, easy go. I have no objection to turning in the opium.
You don't have any opium. All you've got is a big mouth. Me, I'm a sailor. Money's important to me, but more important to me is fair play. These people have never treated us fairly. And if we back down now, these savages will treat us like slaves.
I'm against bloodshed. I say we agree to their terms. Perhaps we can teach them to negotiate in a civil manner.
Listen, listen. I've seen people
smoking opium, and I know what opium is too. It's horrible.
Denton, Urging Wrong is your broker, and you have made a large fortune with his help. Now's your chance to pay him back.
Well, of course, we all know Urging Wrong is innocent. They're just using him to frighten us. We may no more say he is guilty than opium itself. As for Mary, the young girl is naive. Naturally, her vote is dictated by her feelings. But we're grown men. And we know that what we're expecting here is war. In war, gentlemen, we should be prepared to sacrifice our personal feelings for our country. Sorry, Mr. Hearn. The Imperial Kingdom has its laws, and we have our principles.
竟将我中华文字是写得如此丑陋，林则徐三个字也敢写错，天头上竟敢横置两把大刀，书中口口声声两国贸易，泱泱四海，谁敢与天朝并称两？
我看，这不是兵帖，这是战书，洋人只是在试探我林则徐呢，好吗？本大人也正欲向世人昭示我天朝禁烟的决心。来，常务令，立即包围所有的洋人商馆。
进去。摘去你的假发，戴上西帽。
你来看看，咱们的合同事穿这身洋装如何呀？我看他那身换不惯样了。来来来，我们再来看看合同事用洋餐具吃饭。怎么样？
多费一只手啊！哎，是啊，你看啊，这个西洋的餐具要左右开弓啊，两手并用，你看，它就不像我们中国的筷子，是吧？啊，举一反三，变化而无穷啊！
林大人，哎。
刚才商馆里有一个教室，打着白旗走出来，被我们官兵给截下来了。哦，那人在何处？
外堂等候。
阁下，我本可代表英国商馆，我是为个人的名义来作证您的。你一个人来也罢，你们倾巢出动也罢。
我林则徐都在此恭候。
要是要禁绝鸦片，我非常赞成。但是你断水断流，为自己大门的安危。Cutting off food and water is not humane behavior.
他说大人断水断粮，这样太不人道。
我已说的民意，更请您说说怕我呀。
商馆才被围三天，你们就以为不公了。那么中国人被鸦片毒害近百年，家破人亡者上千万，有谁体谅过他们？你主上帝何在？你们那些商人们的仁爱之心又何在？
Where is your God? Where is your humanitarian principle?
嗯，你看一看，这都是你们英吉利的报纸，这上面清清楚楚写着，英王严禁本国吸食鸦片，而且英王还给商人们八条禁约，其中明令往广东不得带违禁物品。那么我请问你，滇地之流为何违抗英王的命令，把鸦片带进中国呢？为防亡国灭种之灾，我林则徐才不得已发兵包围。请你转告商人们，我们中国人已经让了你们一百年，今后我们绝不再让。
You have enjoyed our tolerance for the 100 years until today. We won't yield anymore.
这是如果处处包围，我担心他们 ，they will go on a hunger protest.
如果大人不撤出包围的话，他们将会绝食抗议。
那好，洋人们绝食一天，我林则徐就奉陪一天；洋人绝食到死，我林则徐下地狱向阎王道喜。
If they starve to death, I go down here to express my good wishes.Please.
万一真的有几个洋人饿死，不免令生事端了。
我并不怕洋人，就怕
皇上怕洋人。
我就怕内患不除，他日鸦片必定卷土重来啊。
交出全部账册，所幸我已早有准备。仁贵，我如有不测，你要全力的照顾少爷。
天，还一定会救你出去的。
善知林大人跟洋人斗法，我夹在水火刀枪之间，是断。你要好自为之，先求自保。林则徐那个人城府极深，你帮他做事可千万要小心。
爹，儿想求林大人，那我们要家产赎罪。
对林大人来说，拿银子是买不到命的。到仁贵手里那些账册，必要的时候可以请林大人过目，或许有救。
爹，
老爷，
何家天产地契全部在此，家父宴请叫大人。
好啊。水师正在造军舰炮台，所缺银两正好可以补齐。
是。
这是什么？
家父向大人请罪，这是义和行19年来向官府奉送的银两总册，共计357万6千余两。义和行从来不敢示人，家父获罪是有难言之隐，请大人明察。
听了这本东西，你爸爸何敬荣就该是个砍头的死罪。
大人，
义和行内通贪官，外通洋人，还敢私造密册要挟官府，这么多的官员都上了你们家的账册，向韩兆庆受贿几十万两也就罢了，怎么连这些区区几百两年进的，你们也都把它记录在册，而且还敢拿来给我看？难道你们要让我把广州的官员都斩尽杀绝吗？大敌当前，逼我内乱，你们用心何在？下去。按照我大清律，凡是官宦吸食鸦片者，革爵罢官，停职戴罪。对此，我想在座的都无不熟知。不知诸位有无违禁？
绝无，
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 绝无。
好，既然如此，那今天我们就坐在这里共同的反省自查啊。如果说你能坐满三个时辰安然无恙，敬请大轿回府。如果说连三个时辰也熬不住的话，那么就请你摘下顶戴花翎，停职戴罪。
进一万箱鸦片，就从中抽取200箱，啊，谎称是烟赃。你蒙骗邓大人和关大人向朝廷报功，我看你真是比那些鸦片贩子还要可恨。我中华的威名、天朝的礼仪，就都毁于你们这些鼠辈之手。今天在座的各位，都是朝廷的命官，当为世人之楷模。那么现在我要问一句，有没有人能够说一声啊？我从来没有收受过一两贿银。如果有，请你站出来，当受我林则徐三拜。拿下，日夜看管，严防灭口。
林大人，我是
这是怡和行私造的密册。他们妄图诬陷广州的官员，啊，何景荣还想以此物来为自己赎罪，真是可笑之极。
林大人，
关将军，当是则徐向关将军三拜。
哎呀，林大人，天配一介武夫，从不喜欢试问呐。今天我才看懂林大人这几句话的含义啊。从今往后，任凭林大人差遣，天配万死不辞。廷真，愿同少母兄生死与共。
金烟大爷是任重而道远，今后你我三人只有风雨同舟、甘苦与共，才能共除中华烟毒之大患。
Flag still flying. I'm here by the grace of God, and by the grace of God, I intend to stay here. Now, in the face of this unexpected Chinese violation of our liberty, our resources, and indeed the dignity of the Queen, I am henceforward taking full responsibility for the property and the well-being of the British community here in China.
This is a little bit like shutting the gate after the horse has bolted. We want our ships back. Fine speeches by Captain Elliot is not enough. We want our cargo. We want our ships back. We've been here long enough, gentlemen.
I want my boots back.
Kluder, we have been stuck in here for a long time.
We're not turning in my opium.
We should ask like animals.
Gentlemen! Gentlemen!
Let
us not lose our heads. Now, trade is booming here. Don't let's kill the goose that lays the golden egg. Are you with me? Very well. I will arrange safe passage for you all to leave Guangzhou in the next 10 days.
Guangzhou? What about our...
In the next 10 days, I said, having first handed in all your opium stocks. Every last ounce of it.
What's up, Ben?
You're out of your mind, Captain Elliot. I never heard such lunacy.
Oh, well, well. If it isn't Mr. Denton, risen from the gutter by cheating, swindling, embezzling, and tax evasion. Would you like me to carry on listing your crimes against Her Majesty's government?
That's slander, Captain Elliot.
As for you, Mr. White, I remember you from the Spanish Main. You're nothing more than a smuggler.
How dare you!
As for you, Lawrence, there's not much left in Britain for you, is there? Except for 5 years in jail. You're a lot of fat, greedy rogues, every one of you. I'm not here to help you line your pockets. I'm here to protect Great Britain's trade with China. Now, here's what I propose. I'm offering you all a guarantee of full indemnity against all your losses.
How much are you going to pay?
And what authority, may I ask, do you have to offer such warranties? Does the British government know it will cost them, I would say, in excess of £6 million? What's the Prime Minister going to have to say about that?
We'll have to wait and see, won't we, Denton? In any event, we don't have much choice, do we?
What do you mean?
We are blockaded, are we not? Do you want to sit here in this hellhole till we rot?
No, you call me a criminal. They'll hang you back home for this.
Never mind about me. The Chinese have got you all in a noose. Now, if anyone wants a guarantee, I shall be signing them in my office.
皇天威所向，杨任风马酒对手拜服，现已将所藏鸦片进行成缴，共计22283箱。至此，百年烟祸为之一扫，四海蛮夷倾心向化天朝。
上宏威护佑，鸦片百年烟火已于道光19年4月进行扫灭。
我大清又可盛世再兴，祖上基业传至千秋万载。传旨林则徐，将全部鸦片就地当众销毁，使百姓有目共睹，使四海蛮夷宾服天朝。
Thank you.
臣已到。
Imperial Commissioner, Lin Zexu, the Emperor.
I hope you're very pleased with yourself, Elliot. You've sold us down the river. They're treating us like scum. Come on, move along!
It is beneficial to the people all over the world. Therefore, what I am imposing a ban on is open. Not trade. You all should be grateful to the celestial kindness and abide by the law.
Damn you, Elliot. Damn you to hell.
Denton, wait! Don't be such an obstinate fool.
You're a traitor to us and to your country.
Listen to me, Denton. I want you to take this letter to Lord Palmerston.
What am I now, your errand boy?
In person. Please. Tell him what's going on here. Tell him the Chinese have just burnt £8 million worth of British government stock.
British government stock? That opium was ours.
You all have copies of my guarantee. Well then, the opium they've just burnt is now officially the property of Her Majesty's government.
Do you pretend that your guarantee still holds good?
Of course.
But damn it all, Elliot, you know perfectly well the British government will never part with £8 million.
No, perhaps not. But they might be persuaded to make sure that somebody else does.
Someone else? You mean the Chinese?
Precisely.
You cunning devil, Elliot. You're sending me back home to promote a war. God help me, I'll leave right away.
What's that?
The Imperial Commissioner wants you to give this letter to your queen.
You tell Lin that we will never withdraw. We'll wait offshore. That's where Britain's strength lies. See. You tell Lin that we'll be back to Guangzhou.
Ah, 你说，英国人真的会跟我们大清决战吗？
这。小的不知。 brought us news of the deteriorating situation in Guangzhou. Lives, properties of British citizens being threatened. British commercial chambers have formed themselves into a powerful lobby to exert pressure from all directions upon the government for military interference.
Merchants are interested only in money. Far more important than that, the Chinese do not treat us with equality and fairness. We shall not let them insult the dignity and the honor of Her Majesty the Queen.
He hasn't mentioned the subject of opium.
The government is not involved in the opium trade. That is a free trade conducted by private business.
Gentlemen, I take pride in informing you that some wise men have been engaged for some time in preparing maps of China ever since McCourtney's visit there. Here, on the table, we have a map which shows all the rivers, all the harbors, all the fortifications. A map much more accurate than anything they have in their imperial palace. As for the Chinese Marine Force, it's a fleet of fishing boats, if anything.
A priest convinced us yesterday that one British warship could sink 10 Chinese warships.
Do you believe what he says?
No, I do not. I believe one British warship could destroy the whole Chinese Marine Force.
What have you brought me, my dear friends? Budget, deficit, or war in India?
Your Majesty, I'm inviting you to cut the ribbon for a new railway.
Oh, that's wonderful. I'll do it.
By the way, there is something important that Palmerston has to report to you.
In China, Your Majesty, Len Zhezhu has destroyed £8 million worth of our goods and is driving all the British residents out of Guangzhou.
Well, what shall we do then?
We're looking forward to your instructions.
But I hear you're already assembling marine forces.
Sample of a new stamp to be released shortly. What do you think?
She looks prettier, doesn't she?
Your Majesty, the world is never short of beautiful women. There is only one British queen.
Thank you for your honesty, Melbourne.
The stamp will be distributed to every country in the British Empire. My dear, where there is sunshine, there is your image.
And in China, too?
Your Majesty, the Cabinet is looking forward to your support for the motion to send the army to China and for parliamentary support for military appropriations.
Now tell me, what kind of a man Lin Zhezhu is?
Well, he's strong-willed, unrefined, loyal to his emperor, liable to go to extremes. I confess that our knowledge of that thousand-year-old empire is somewhat limited.
I wish I could see him in Madame Tussaud's museum. If I were in Lin Zexu's position, I would also burn all the opium. But now it's not the opium issue, nor the issue of the lives and properties of a few merchants. It's not even a matter of the dignity of our British flag and royalty. If all nations follow China's example and reject free trade, the British Empire will no longer exist within a year. This is the reason for us to use force. We must teach them a lesson on free trade. Gentlemen, Britain has the responsibility to open up this last and largest territory in the East. I hope you won't tell me one day that this has been done by other countries. The fact is, whoever gets hold of China will have the entire East. The 19th century.
既不肯降，又不肯退，他们死守在海上到底是要干什么呢？这定是等待英王命令吧。英国人以商为本，战端一开必然中断贸易，对他们有什么好处啊？这个道理滇地不懂，英国国王应该清楚。
Member for Richmond upon Thames.
There are 400 million people living in China. If that many people lived in Europe, they would have separated into hundreds of countries years ago. But the Chinese have always been ruled by one emperor and spoken one language. Is this not formidable? For 5,000 years, do you not think that we should be making trade with these people and not war?
They have banned the trade.
They have treated the British Empire badly.
They really should be punished.
Order! The Honourable Member for Hampstead and Highgate.
There's one thing I'd like to call your attention to. Britain has the most advanced industry in the world.And China has the biggest market. If every Chinese were to lengthen the lower hem of his shirt by 1 inch, all the British factories would be kept in business for 30 years.
Order! The father of the house, Sir Alexander Matheson.
Speaker.
Gentlemen.I know two strange names, Confucius and Zhongzi. They lived in China over 2,000 years ago, before Aristotle and Socrates. And their thoughts are even more profound than those of Socrates and Aristotle. In all probability, Mr. Speaker, it will take us generations to understand the profundity of their thought and to understand China.It is a country with a huge wall, thousands of miles long in the north, and a great canal of thousands of miles in the south. Mr. Speaker, it was a great nation. But even in sleep, they are unpredictable. Yes, we may be able to defeat them, but we can never conquer them. I have one ambition left for my life. It is to visit China.
but I would rather swim the Atlantic than sail down in a battleship.
Calculate. Are you sure you're ready? Tell you the truth. Objection is so strong, the motion will probably be rejected. I'm afraid.
Gentlemen, I come before you to present the plight of a group of defenseless British subjects blockaded in an attempt to starve them into submission, made to surrender their property in trade, which was then destroyed, who were then driven from their quarters in Guangzhou to be confined aboard our ships at sea without food, without water, without medicine, there to float under the pestilent heat of the sun. If you but... Before I set out on my journey to England, I was obliged to take leave of my daughter, who, being sick, was unable to travel with me. I may never see her alive again.
And yet, our glorious Union Jack still flaps high on our mast. Gentlemen, your countrymen and your sovereign have been grievously wronged. They look to you for reparation. To that end, your representative in China, Captain Charles Elliot, gave me letters which I have delivered to the Prime Minister. There are also gifts to be delivered to the house.
This is a piece of Chinese bronzeware made over 2,000 years ago. It is adorned with figures of sacred spirits representing their highest ideals. Bronze was the strongest metal then known to the world. Ever since that time, the Chinese have called themselves the Han. This vase is carved from a single piece of jade. It dates from the Tang Dynasty, the golden age of China. Not only was this the most prosperous period in the history of China, but also the most civilized people, the most cultured in the world. This is a work of art from the China of today. Like the great Qing dynasty it represents, it appears sumptuously rich, plump, and proud. It looks down on all around it, including the bronze and the jade. And yet it is filled with nothing but self-importance. One touch, and it will shatter to pieces. This
is the China I offer you.
Mr. Elliot, I'd like to remind you that our food stocks are running low. We can't feed on cannon powder now, can we? As captain of the ship, I need to know your intentions.
Wait.
Wait! Wait for what? For death?
Yeah. Into thy hands, O Lord, we commend the soul of this thy son.
Of this our dearly departed brother to the deep. May the Lord have mercy on his soul. Amen.
Charles, for heaven's sakes, let's weigh anchor and go home, or we'll have many more dead.
Told you before, you can go back to your church in Macau.
Oh, no. I'm needed here. You're leading these people to death.
Her Majesty's government will not let them die in vain.
Yes, and that's what you want, isn't it? Not rescue, but a cause for war. That's what you wanted since the day you came here. You're the devil! You knew!
禀林大人，英舰连枪而来，已至虎门，并封锁了珠江海口。
来，我们先下完这盘棋。
Bremer, I know these waters like the back of my hand. If we attack now, we can take Guangzhou by nightfall.
How well do you know Lin Zexu, Mr. Elliot? Resistance here in Guangzhou of the Great Qing is Peking. Let's settle our account with their emperor. That will affect the Great Sphere.
Mm-hmm. tricky customer to deal with, Lin Zexu. Strange, isn't it? Never met my old adversary face to face.
Larry 大人，贼船见我严阵以待，不战而逃。
哦，
那洋人可是退至远海？
卑职见他们进行北上。
少穆，哎呀，这下去。
洋人并非退逃，一定是北上金军。
速派战船追杀，或许能够拖住敌舰。
洋人船坚炮利，航速极快。600里快骑，火速禀报皇上，并通报沿途各地。
这，
其实我是宁愿意在广州与洋人决一死战。
不准备攻占定海，但要借用这个可爱的岛，为舰队补充给养和淡水。我们会付钱。
If you don't agree, we'll wipe you out.
如果你们抵抗，我们就消灭你们。
Yes or no?
请快回答是还是不是。They're always like this. This is so typically Chinese. They never say yes and they never say no.
Stand by. Open fire.I feel like talking now.
这下你该开口了。
从来没见过这么大的船。
He's never seen ships so great.
也没见过这么狠的炮。
Our cannon's so powerful.
但是我必须抵抗。
But he feels he must resist.
大清官兵有死无降。
The officials and soldiers of the Great Qing.Would rather die than surrender.
Cut!
承天朝泱泱大国，不到一个时辰，定海的七座炮台、十余艘战船就成了灰烬，几百大清子民命丧黄泉。
军门600里快马告急，洋人七日前攻占定海。
啊！
定海失陷，那贼船是不是正在北上啊？
皇上，直隶总督琦善大人求见。
臣琦善叩请圣安，君臣。应舰队开抵天津大沽口，
闯到皇宫禁地来了。林则徐呢？为何不见他在广州退敌呢？
哦，臣刚刚接到杨仪转给圣上的信。
八脉尊是什么人？
此蛮夷官居一品啊，是英吉利的外交大臣。
那英吉利不过是一个弹丸小岛，做大清的属国都不配，怎么敢随便的给朕上书？
依臣所见，对英仪不能姑息。再者，天朝化外子民正多，什么法兰西、米利坚都学了样，那还了得？应当迎头痛击，驱逐出海才为上策。
那英人船坚炮利，霸居海上，奴才在大沽口亲眼看见了。
怎么样？
恕奴才死罪，
照实奏来。
那英人的战船舰炮为奴才生平所未见，那战船航行在海上，它竟比烈马还快。那舰炮分上下三层，发炮时如雷霆万钧。
林则徐不会办事，如今鸦片尚未除尽，不料战乱又起，连夜恶报不断，林则徐误国误朕误天下。
皇上明鉴，洋人北上皆因为林则徐造次，不如明令撤免林则徐。
什么？
如此可以先决掉洋人用兵之口实，然后再以礼相待，劝其退兵，妥善解决事端。
不可！洋人有罪，洋人用鸦片毒害中华，林则徐魂硝烟，功不可没。而今洋人有罪，反而带入上宾，林则徐有功，反而被罢官多职，堂堂大清岂能受这种奇耻大辱啊！
皇上，林则徐只不过是一人的去留臣服，江山社稷才是大清的命脉。
皇上，臣担心琦善所言失约于敌，使洋人得寸进尺。
罢了，洋人嘛，
野蛮无知。朕决定先礼后兵。岐山，你世受皇恩，又系朝廷的栋梁，朕要你速返天津，安抚洋人。朕已免了林则徐，并且宽恕洋人擅动兵戈之罪。朕任命你为钦差大臣，全权解决争端。
臣领旨。
梁皇古都林则徐接旨。
传梁皇总督林则徐接旨。
临阵易帅，这凶兆啊！
实不相瞒，撤免少穆兄是我岐善向皇上进言呢。哎，洋人动兵皆因我翻烧鸦片而起嘛，要剿灭兵患，首先要化解争端，然后再恩威并用，方可不战而屈人之兵嘛。少傅兄啊，为保大清的江山社稷，你我做臣子的性命都可以不要，这区区的仕途功名又何足挂齿呢？岐山向兄台定能理解。岐山告罪。
洋人是为了我林则徐而来，那么我敬请岐山大人砍去我林某的人头，拿去退地。我林则徐必定含笑受辱。
严重了，谋和嘛，就要以诚信为先呢。撤免兄台，就是为了表示我方的诚信啊。
洋人的坚船利炮就倚门而立。我不信凭着三寸巧舌就可以退敌。
那么兄台你有何见教啊？啊，
洋人的目光之远，兵力之强，野心之大，远非你我所能够想象。除了调集全国的兵力与之一战，别无他途。
这是数月前才上奏皇上说洋人不会开战，开了战也不是我是对手啊。要不是你这么自信，这么狂妄，洋人出兵，朝廷上也不会这么猝不及防吧。你如今要强力的抵战，轻敌的是你，引敌来犯的又是你，把大清推向血海干戈的还是你。
当初何须实乃是井底之蛙，不知天下之大事，今日才知道世界上已经是强国林立，国破林头了。
那你怎么知道你今天就不是井底之蛙呢？
齐大人，老夫戎马一生，胸无点墨，谋和乃大人所长，天培唯愿死战。
老将军，你一口一个战死，
你可有战胜的信心吗？
你们几位在座的大人，你们谁能必操胜券？
我齐善言率先赴敌。
老将军不怕死，我齐善皇亲一脉，世受国恩，反倒我贪生怕死不成吗？这在天津大沽口，我亲眼所见洋人的船舰炮利，我是做梦也想不到，我说句掉头的话吧，大清国的三星到了。
是啊，如果说不战而降，那离亡国是不远了。
少牧，
强敌临门不足畏，天翻地陷不恐惧，就是不能让读书人沦丧。
大人，小人还是想留在大人身边，跟着大人。
你呀，太过虚荣。吃得了一时苦，你不能吃苦一世。
是，小人知道，小人会继续留在广州，搜集资料，供林大人编书。
我想了好多天。洋人的服装虽说难看，可是他们行动方便；刀叉虽说粗鲁，可是连吃饭都用铁器。这样的民族。不可小看呐！
哎呀，你们何家果真是富甲天下呀！啊，何善之，我此次到广州来，主要是和洋人周旋。你既然老和他们一起打交道，那你一定知道。他们最喜欢什么了？啊？
洋人也是肉骨繁星啊，关大人喜欢什么，洋人也就喜欢什么。
我想让你做一件事，为国效劳。你若能办成，我就赦免你父亲的死罪。哎，
小人愿竭尽全力。
好，
要他跟洋人，我怕他不肯。
他不肯。你知道荣儿是什么人？他是芒月氏的孙女儿。想当年，他在乾隆爷的身边是四品带刀侍卫，后来冒犯天颜，刺瞎了双眼，逃出生命，在江湖上隐居30年。我掌握他们两人的生命。他敢说不去，那王月氏，他是要犯。
要犯？
爷爷，您多保重。我要出一次远门。
Yeah.
茹毛饮血，生性好战呐、啊。
You're born bellicose, as you like to eat bleeding food.
I understand that the Chinese cuisine is unrivaled anywhere in the world. I can't say as much for your cannons. If you'd applied just a little of your expertise in cookery to the manufacture of cannon, it would be we who today was begging for a truce.
他很了解中国的美食天下无双，但中国的炮台却是一堆垃圾。如果我们把智慧放在炮台上的话，今天求和的就换是他们。
哦，我此次来不是求和，是赐和。哎哎，赐和，赐和。
I'm here not to ask for truth, but to grant truth.
I don't care what you call it. We don't care.
怎么说都行，他不计较名称。
我们皇帝看尔等尚属恭顺，特赏赐白银300万两，作为你们舰船归国的花销。啊。
His Majesty the Emperor knows that you have behaved with respect and submission, and therefore bestows on you 3 million taels of your silver to cover the expenses of your trip home.
Who said anything about going home? No. What we want.We want 6 million taels of silver to compensate for the opium. We want the opening up of 5 ports for trade. Most of all, we want Hong Kong.
他们要的是600万两的鸦片赔款，开放5口通商口岸，而最主要的是香港。
那不行，我们大清国从来没有过割地的事情。哎呦。
Our Qing dynasty has never ceded its territory before.
Well, you will now.
哎呀，你们要这个地方有什么用呢？你们应该先拿到，啊，先拿到钱嘛。
Why do you want Hong Kong? Money is important.
No, no, no. It'll be invaluable to us. We reckon that Hong Kong is the best port in the whole Far East.Yes, it's perfect location, excellent climate, deep water, it's ideal.
他们发现远东最好的港口就是香港，那的气候、水深和地理位置，他们都测量过了。
And we must have it.
他必须得到它。
我们皇帝的脾气，你们是不能要这么多东西的吧？
I know perfectly well the temperament of His Majesty the Emperor. You can't ask for so much all at once. You'd better ask for money first.
And I know perfectly well the temperament of Her Majesty the Queen. It's her birthday coming up soon, and we must find a suitable present for her. Hong Kong will be ideal.
他说他们也非常了解他们女王的脾气。他们的女王生日快到了。没有比香港更好的礼物。
Look, I have to tell you that if you don't agree to our condition, we will attack Guangzhou at once.
他说，如果我们不同意的话，他立刻攻打广州。
好，不过你们要等我。禀明我们的大皇帝。
But you must let me report to His Majesty the Emperor.
现在你已经是我们大皇帝的人了。
往后这个你们所有的饮食啊、花销啊，都由我们来款待吧。啊。
From now on, you're a guest of the Qing Dynasty, so you'll be entertained at all expenses.
Heavens! I wish we got this treatment at home.
Well, now I can see that you're sincere in your quest for peace. I'll extend the ceasefire for another month.
他说他相信我们的和平诚意，他将休战日期延长为一个月。
我想，我们不会再开战喽。
I don't believe that we'll start the war.
Good. Good. We shall take over Hong Kong in 10 days' time.
他必须在十天之内接管香港。
But of course, we will need a letter from your emperor confirming our conditions. If we don't receive this in 1 month, we can only take it as a declaration of war.
他在一个月之内必须得到皇上认可他们的所有正式文件，否则他将认定是我们在对他宣战。
Their smiles, but not their bodies. And besides, you have promised to let them go. But she's willing to stay on and look after you.
I'll tell you something. They're planning to get rid of me. Do you realize who I am?Who masterminded the whole thing? About me, there wouldn't be any British troops here at all. It's as if I was a farmer. Bought a cow, reared it.After it, fed it, got it fattened up, and then, when it was ready for slaughter, it's as if they wanted to send me back. I tell you.I wasn't going to get a share of the meat. Then I would have helped Lin Zizhu, been his advisor. Oh, Maybe even I married you. Oh, so beautiful. So beautiful. She's done to me. Look at that, eh? She had these scissors. Clothing. And a blow brains out.
For God's sake, Elliot. Don't be a bloody fool. Send her back to Qishan for punishment.
You're a奴才呀，你进入了天朝的大事，你竟让这么一个女人去安抚杨仪。
什么时候可以起行了？祺善大人给你送礼来了。祺善大人命，何老爷既爱娥芙蓉，就该陪伴此物终生。
Thank you.
臣以为万万不可以轻言开战，洋人是船坚炮利，来去如风，这茫茫数千里海岸，我们如何能够处处重兵把守呢？
兵勇不够，可招募民团，自卫乡土，抵御外贼。林则徐曾招募民团，却被琦善解散，乃至广州城防空虚，此琦善误国之又一大罪状。
琦善罪孽深重，
皇上，此意如同谋反呢、招募民团，武装百姓，这是国之大计呀、万一乱民惑众闹事，反戈一己，那么大清王朝还有安生的日子吗？香港只不过是一个蛮荒小岛，与大清而言，九牛一毛，弃子无损。皇上，如果说用香港来换取内地的平安，实乃朝廷幸事。
皇上，大清开国200年来，只有开疆扩土，牧马千山，何曾有过割地赔款、丧臣辱国？香港之离开，定将祸水横流，那时我等就是卖国之臣，皇上就成了乱世之君呐！
放肆！
皇上，你要是把香港赐予洋人，老夫我就撞死在这滩上！
议和，朕深知其害；开战，朕也深知其害。朕决定调集各省骑勇、陆营、水师、战船，与洋人开战。血肉之标，血肉骨骼皆受之于父母，你把他带回家乡，葬进祖坟。阿三，你从家乡出来，跟随我40余年，两次将我从刀枪下救出，大恩大德，来生再报吧。此刻只求你一句，再别回来啊。
你叫我下跪吧。
我们听好了，冀中鹰箭一炮，赏银50两；冀臣一艘，赏银500两。
是意思吗？
大帅，有脸来见我！大帅，我滚滚缠朝廷，伤不朝廷，家不百姓，我该死！可我辱骂一声喊，大帅，现在英兵犯我疆土，求大帅，让我这个要被处死的人死在这炮台上吧，大帅！
好，我承认。明年的今天就是我的忌日，谢大帅。
I do. The Chinese believe that devoting their life to justice is right. It's a belief that in fact can destroy any war.
则许此次承蒙圣上言谕，不敢不恋天威。则许别无他求，只求圣上能令臣戴罪立功，随迎杀敌，臣必当单节血偿，以死报国。关将军，大将。
老爷，老爷，你怎么来了？啊，老爷，一路送到武庙，我回来给您收尸。<笑>好，好，
阿三，
啊，
我今天不瞑目。
哎呀，这么好的炮台！
败得这么窝囊，败得我心里出血呀！老爷，啊！嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，嘿，
提善欺君卖国，丧权革地，着即革去连光总督钦差大臣之职，押解入京，斩监候。林则徐虚言误国，惹动兵讯，着即发配新疆。
臣叩谢皇恩。
叩谢皇恩。
下人一路上要多保重，
多多谢了。广州方面的事情，不拜。
回上康。
好了，就送到这儿吧。
多保重啊，
多保重。
多保重。
上次告诉他。
保重。
哎，这不是齐善吗？
遭惨败，可你虽败犹荣，或能名垂千古。我齐善啊，身败名裂，永悲骂名啊。
则徐既来广州，个人的祸福早已置之度外。只是今后，我中华怕是要进入漫漫长夜。
苍天已有眼，天朝无望啊！
林生。则许此生怕是无缘再见到皇上，而齐善大人则未必。今后如果有机会能够再见到圣上，请一定代则许将此物呈现给皇上，一定要告诉皇上，如今这世界上已经是强国林立，我大清朝再也不能闭目塞听，做井底之蛙了。
大人，请上路吧。